cruising. I've been on Devi music with the shits, and you know when chaos make a beat, you know that beat gon' hit. Then we got that boy Diesel Devin, nigga whipping shit. Then there's Jordan, Jimmy, Mexico, fuck with the fashion shit. Take off, then I'm smashing shit. Fucking buy another if I crash your shit. Shitting on you niggas like I'm really taking laxatives. Bitch, don't hype your homie up, I hate to have to whack the kid. They like better cut the BIV about this. My nigga, what's happening? We done got the Devi kid to rap again. Riding in CC, better believe you keep a strap with him. Even the gap with him, ride 100 grand and rap with him. Don't fuck with the boy, Nickapedia niggas will clap with him.
Y'all want to introduce? Y'all want to do the intro?
I guess so.
Ronnie camera look crisp as shit right now for some reason. Oh shit. All right.
So,
what's good, Nickapedia? It's your boy. Hold up. I don't know if y'all niggas can hear me. What's good, Nickapedia? It's your boy, Devi Music, aka Sean.
Damn,
cuz,
you talking fast?
Yeah, talk fast when you're YouTuber.
So you don't fuck up, you know what I'm saying? Because it's a set thing that I do every time, so if I do it fast, I won't fuck it up.
Yeah, bro.
That makes sense, bro. But it's Diesel, dude.
All right, hold on. Let me try.
You know, it's King Chaos Beats, you know.
Can y'all still hear me? Is my mic still working?
Right in the demo.
Yeah. Right. We TV for it around here.
You did your headphones, G?
Yeah. Hopefully it's TV. It records the same, I think. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And, you know what I'm saying? Nigga hair getting long, so we can't just really have the headphones on like that no more, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My shit is getting long, though. It's only been like a month.
Yeah, because you mix, bro. Like, you got, your jeans get you disqualified, bro. Biracial.
I got that biotin, nigga. Them good products.
You got that biotin.
It's built in his head, too.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, bro. You got a natural factory of biotin.
You got that limited edition.
I guess,
bro,
this
the only time I was.
I guess this will be the first episode of the new year. It's the first one we're recording this year.
Because we ain't got no type of agenda. We just talking. I was trying to set up
Discord shit, and that shit wasn't working. So now niggas got to finish the setup because I'm not trying nothing else.
Niggas, aka me.
Bro, but like next time, bro.
Go ahead and say your question.
Why do people think that moving to the city is just a remedy to solve all their problems, bro?
Now,
like people, like I see people, like, don't get me wrong, Lubbock ain't just, you know, the best Lubbock of towns out here.
Yeah.
But you can build some in Lubbock, bro. Like, people think that you have to escape Lubbock. And some people do. But,
yeah,
you know, people just think, like, oh, if I move to Houston, it'll be better. Oh, if I move to Dallas, I'll this and that. And
I have more to do.
And, you know, they may think, oh, it's more to do. It's more to this, this and that. I'm like, bro, but it's a difference between visiting Dallas, you know, visiting a big city and living in a big city. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
bro. So, I see both sides from this, though.
Yeah.
Because what I don't understand is people moving to the big city without a plan, you know?
Yeah. But you notice most of them move back.
Yeah, bro. They gonna be back because it's the same shit. Like,
bro,
if you don't have a plan in Lubbock, Texas, and you move to the big city, you ain't gonna have a plan in the big city.
You just gonna be there.
You gonna be there, and you just gonna be the same Lubbock motherfucker in Dallas.
Because y'all niggas know me. I've been a New York nigga at heart since birth. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Brooklyn. You know what I'm saying? They be fucking up.
Oh, my God.
Sorry, you ever been to New York, bro?
I've been through New York, going to New Hampshire.
Been in spirit. Going to New Hampshire? Oh, okay.
But no, I'm going to end up in New York. Like, when I retire and shit,
you gonna be there.
A nigga going to live in New York one of these motherfuckers.
My boy going to be in the Bronx one day, bro.
Yeah, I'm gonna be running. Yeah, bro. I'm gonna be running Harlem, nigga. That's my shit, nigga. You know what I'm playing?
You're gonna be one of the only people to get rich and move to the hood.
Nigga.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm gonna be outside like a motherfucker, boy.
I'm gonna
move into like the city, bro. Cause by that time I'm gonna have it, so rent ain't gonna be shit. So I'm just, yeah, I want to be like, I want to be in the middle of every fucking thing, bro.
That's a plan, though, bro. You know, like,
yeah, bro. So, like, with me, the only
I got to be able to live in Georgia first, though.
Yeah, real talk.
Bro, low key, I do kind of want to move to Georgia, though, bro.
That's hey, man. We should do it, bro.
Yeah, I want to move to Atlanta. You know,
boy, yeah, bro, really bro real shit, bro. Boy. I will transfer schools right now. I will go fill out that fucking application, my man.
Bro.
Yeah, but we have a plan, ages, though. We know what we going to do when we end up in another city.
I might call my baby mama in Atlanta, to be honest with you, bro. So I might not need to move there right now.
This nigga.
Hey, I'm going to just say. Your kid bro. Come out sounding like 21 Savage, bro.
Bro, I don't care, bro.
That nigga is British.
Jams, bro.
He knows. 21 Savage talks like an Atlanta nigga.
Bro, ain't nothing like them Georgia sweet brown sugar yams, bro. Ain't nothing like it.
Bro, shut up. Hey,
bro, Sean, you know, bro. I'm okay, man. We're going to get back.
We're going to get back
on topic, bro.
Oh, my
God. But my thing is, bro, like, if you struggling to make it here in Lubbock, what make you think moving to Dallas is going to automatically fix your problems?
It's not.
Like, sure.
And people going to figure it out, and they're going to move back.
Exactly, like, sure, bro, like, you gonna get paid more, but hell, you gotta pay more to live in Dallas.
Yeah, bro. So, like, people always tell me, because I get this a lot, they're like...
The cost of living is more than it is here.
Cost of living in Lubbock is great. I don't know what people be talking about. Cost of living in Lubbock is, like, amazing, bro.
Shit, not at Lubbock Christian University. Man, these bitches expensive. Oh,
well. we ain't talking about no private institution. I'm talking about...
We ain't talking about the YTs.
Them Christians want their money, where?
What?
Pay banks.
I bet it's still cheaper than Tech. Because Tech is public, and they just said, nah.
What is y'all's dorm pricing? Do you know?
Bro, I think a dorm price is like around like $12,000 or something crazy.
Yeah, I was just about that too. With meal plan.
Damn.
Yeah.
No, that's not meal plan. That's just $12,000 room and board only.
I should
meal plans by itself be like an extra like $500 or something crazy. Yeah.
Become a RA, kids. Get that free room.
Yes, time. Become a RA, kids. Best advice to you.
Get that free room. Hey, real shit, nigga.
Better advice. Go to early college and get half of that shit done in high school, bro. Yeah. Oh, that kills me.
If you get a professor named Henrietta Goodman, you need to appreciate that woman, okay?
Oh my gosh. Realest professor
I've ever had. I'm not even gonna bleep her name out.
Oh yeah, she's a great
professor. I give her all her props, bro.
Realest one I've ever had. I don't care if any of my other professors the best one, get through her.
Bro, I don't care. I don't care if the nigga that was making the what's his name? I call him Doofus Schmerz. The nigga
Klaus.
Klaus.
I thought about the nigga Klaus. For last.
Yeah.
I don't remember that nigga name.
I call him Dukes and Schmerz.
I'm gonna check my Blackboard, see if I still got him on that.
This nigga still got his Blackboard password.
Well, oh, bro, I go to Tech.
He's still using
it. I
just forgot about this. It's like,
yeah, bro. Can't go to Tech now, so they kick my ass out.
She was the best professor ever. But we still veer back off topic. Yeah. But,
nah, bro, I'm about to figure out this dude's name.
Like,
oh, bro, it don't even tell you.
I've seen two. I don't think these bitches is in school, but I've seen two bitches that graduated after us that moved. Do y'all know who I'm talking about before I have to
tell
myself through more work?
Yeah.
Roddy,
yeah. No. I'll tell you
right now. Names start with it.
And they sisters.
Yeah, sisters? I didn't know that shit.
Yeah.
Damn.
Devin text me, bro. Devin just text me.
I'll edit it. Yeah. I'll edit that shit out.
Sisters, bro.
As long as we just don't keep saying it.
Okay. Now, too.
Yeah. Well, no. Maybe not. They don't watch our shit. Fuck them bitches.
But continue.
But they moved all the way down there, and from what social media says, they're doing pretty fine.
Doing pretty fine? Well, you know, social media is also
that's why I said social media.
Cause social ain't nothing cap harder than a social media, bro.
Bro, like, cause you don't know, like, social media could be like, yeah, they doing fine, but then them niggas down there like sharing Vienna wings and crackers on the weekend. Like, bro, you don't know.
They doing fine, but then they have their struggle.
That shit's so an extreme. Hey, so yeah, but them bitches broke for it.
Bro. That's hilarious. Bro, and it's like, I don't knock nobody hustle, you know, but some of these niggas is wild, and bro, like, moving to the city, bro, like.
Like, real talk, I'm a person that enjoys stability, right? I'm never going to put myself in a situation where I'm not stable. Not on purpose. People be purposefully putting themselves in unstable situations. And I'm just like, why? You know?
Like, I think people just think
I understand,
fall in love with the idea of the city, bro. But
I understand
they don't realize what you
gotta
do to make it in the city, though, bro.
Yeah, bro. Like, I understand taking a risk and all that stuff. What I do not understand, however, is letting that risk literally dictate your entire life to a point to where you ain't able to succeed in anything, you know?
Yeah.
That's some harsh words right there, dude. Some real harsh words, but it's facts. You know, take a risk all you want, but don't let that risk literally ruin everything that you got going for yourself.
Yeah, bro, like, I feel that, because I see some people, so many people be like, yeah, bro, I'm moving to the city, this, that, man, this.
Yeah.
But then they down talk their own city, you know, where they grew up from, and I'm like, bro, like, moving away ain't helping that, though, you know?
Yeah, bro, some people are like, I'm moving to the city and get my life together. No, bro, you get your life together here first, because your life don't, if your life together is here right now, it's going to get unshackled once you move to the big city. That's just factual.
You can't say you're moving to get your life together. Like, bro, if your life together, ain't together here, what made you think Dallas is going to be like, all right, let's get our life together?
Yeah, the city of Dallas going to be like, oh, yeah, let's help this little nigga. Like,
let's just go over to his crib.
The nigga's going to band together.
On me, bro. Like, no.
Now, Dallas, like, yeah, bro, you don't screw yourself. And you know, we picking on Dallas a lot, even though Dallas is like my favorite city and all that, but it's true.
People do that, bro.
Going to Dallas is just gonna save your life. You know, I'm gonna be real with you. If you wanna move,
honestly, we're just saying Dallas because we're niggas from Texas, and that's where niggas from Texas tend to go.
Well, no,
bro, like from Lubbock. Everybody from Lubbock is in Fort Worth.
Yeah. Now, if we were in a different state, it would be something. We would be saying something different.
Yeah, you know, if you're trying to move to Albuquerque, you know.
See, yeah, and if niggas from New Mexico, that's probably where they all go flock to.
Well, yeah, that's where they go. Like,
that's probably where they flock to. That's like how they flock to L.A.
And how they go to Denver and all them places, bro. I mean, what you go, you in Kansas? Kansas City. That's in Missouri, though, but I mean.
You go it's leave, nigga, that's what niggas in Kansas do.
No, Topeka, that's what it's called.
They'll go anywhere else, my name.
What about South Dakota, bro?
you
this nigga name
is, for me.
This nigga I'm named weak ass states. This nigga said South Dakota.
Well, I ain't heard of Dakota in a minute, man.
Fuck both of the Dakotas, nigga.
I ain't heard nothing about Dakotas, man.
Yeah, one of them got Mount Rushmore, the other one is just...
For real? That's what it is?
Yeah,
wow, I thought that shit was in D.C., my nigga. I'm fucking with that.
Oh, my God.
D.C. ain't got no mountains, bro.
I don't know shit, bro.
D.C.
Them shit's just
water,
sculptures,
bro.
Though, my nigga. You could carve them fucking things into anything.
You really could.
But D.C., bro, D.C.
That makes sense, though. That's not a bad guess. That's where the president's in D.C. The nigga be. That's not a bad deal.
Yeah,
I didn't say, like, I thought the bitches was in Baltimore or something like that.
Bro, but even then, though, like, Sweetwater. I thought them motherfuckers was in Paducah.
Mm-hmm.
And them motherfuckers, you know, South Amarillo somewhere. Boy. Yeah, somewhere up over there. But yeah, bro, I mean, think about it. If just because you live in Lubbock don't mean you in a terrible spot. If you live in Lubbock, you in a better place than the entire state of Wyoming. Like, real talk.
Nigga said Wyoming. Wyoming.
Bro, but like, I know like people like I went and did work for, bro. Like, they own companies in cities, bro. But they be living right here in Lubbock. And I asked this one dude, because he owns like this whole oil field company that's ran in Midland or whatever. Oh. And you know he getting banked.
If he got an oil company in Midland,
if you own an oil field company, bro, and you live in like a 2-story house out in the middle of nowhere, Lubbock.
Fuck, I cannot do
that. Yeah.
But he got shot behind his house. Like, fuck, I ain't gonna get too personal into it.
Go ahead and get personal.
I could not live nowhere. That's in. I could not live in the middle of nowhere, bro.
Bro, he don't live in the middle of nowhere, but he live in Woodrow.
Oh yeah.
I don't know where the fuck that is.
It's in Cooper area, bro.
South Lubbock. Basically, where the city's at.
I still couldn't do that.
It's still in the city limits, though.
Bro, the place I live right now, like the area that LCU is in, is fucking perfect, bro. I'm around a lot of shit.
Yeah. Bro, I think that's where me and Sean are different.
Yeah, bro, I cannot, bro. Ma would not be able to live, bro.
Me and Devin, for sure, are a lot more southern in the fact, Texan, I should say, in the fact that we can live by ourselves in, like, the
middle. You can just call me redneck.
Hell no. I live by
I ain't gonna call you a redneck, bro.
I live by myself. I'm not gonna live in middle of fucking nowhere. Like, I could not live in Seagraves, bro. Like, I don't understand. I couldn't live in that type of. I fuck with Brownfield, and I got family in Brownfield, but I could not fucking live there, bro. It is not shit there, bro.
I would never live in Brownfield, bro.
Like, I can completely understand you, but, like, I'm more of a suburbs type of dude, bro.
Yeah, bro, me too. I'm more of a, you know, go out, way outside of the city, it's calmer, but you can still get to Walmart when you need to. You know,
bro. See, that's not bad.
Move to Dallas. I can move to Grapevine, Grand Prairie, Weatherford, or something like that.
The last shit I could do, like, the extent of my shit would probably be, like, wherever the fuck Wayland is. Where is that, Plainview or some shit?
Plainview?
Where is Wayland at?
I ain't gonna move to Plainview. I ain't gonna live in Plainview.
That's probably, like, the extent. I might be, like, down bad a couple days, but that's, like, the extent of my shit, boy.
I'm gonna be real. If you live in Plainview, I could kind of understand moving to Dallas. I could kind of see going to Dallas.
Niggas, they have a fucking. I know for a fact Plainview has a fucking mall at least. I've been there.
Plainview have a mall?
When we were doing some shit at Wayland, bro, we ate at the mall. I think. It might not have been Plainview.
But you know there's a Wayland here too, right?
No, it wasn't here. I know for sure it wasn't here.
I've never been to this mall in Plainview, bro. I know what he's talking about. All the little stores. Am I right? It said mall, my nigga.
If I remember right. It's been a long time. I'm not going to lie. It's been 4 years. 5 years.
Was it a strip mall or like,
I don't fucking know, bro. Like, is Wayland even in Plainview? Let's figure that out first. It is?
Yeah. Yeah. I know that for sure.
I remember there being a mall somewhere around that bitch, bro, because we ate there.
I also don't live in Plainview either, so.
Yeah, that's what
I don't know what's in Plainview.
I've been there twice, my
nigga. I ain't never seen no mall there.
I've been there twice.
I go through Plainview, but I don't really work in Plainview.
Yeah, bro, all I see is the big water tower, and I'll be like, oh, yeah, we're about halfway to Amarillo. That's what I'll be saying.
All I do, like, well, we're in Plainview.
I couldn't live in Amarillo either, bro.
Nah, bro.
Bro, actually, Amarillo is really better than Lubbock, bro.
I wouldn't say that. Nah, you went a little bit farther, man. I don't know about that.
Well, far as, like, being spread out, bro, like, how Lubbock ain't got nothing on the east side.
Well, yeah, Amarillo grew like a normal city. Lubbock didn't, but still, Lubbock.
Bro, like, if Lubbock shared the wealth like Amarillo did with both its sides of towns, bro. I swear to you, Lubbock would be a metro place right now, bro.
Well, that's the thing. At least on the inside, on the east side, at the border of the east side, it's something, my nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. on the border of the east side, like
well, if you live in fucking Seagraves, it's like not at the border of Seagraves. There still ain't shit on the border of Seagraves, my man. You still gotta go all the way to Seminole to go get some shit.
You gotta go to Seminole, bro.
My gosh, bro.
Man,
let's
feel like we gotta go to Slayton to go to Walmart.
Like, fuck no. I'm not even finna. Nigga, we have 12 Walmarts in fucking Lubbock, bro. Like, I am.
Too many.
I am very much so concerned.
Bro, and not one of them east of I-27. Think about that.
Eastside Walmart is Avenue Q, bro. That's the
Eastside Walmart is Tech Walmart, bro.
Yeah. We got the Eastside Walmart is the border of the east side.
Once you cross that Walmart, you're not on Eastside Walmart, you are in the hood immediately.
You are not on Eastside
Walmart. Once you cross back across I-27, you're back in the hood.
Yeah, even part of the Depot District. Like, once you get close to I-27, that's like, all right. It's like,
you are on that borderline. You're on that borderline.
You know, people get shot over there, man. You gotta be careful. Like on Crickets Avenue and Buddy Holly and all that, you gotta be careful.
Yeah, bro. I couldn't live in those. That's why like New York attracts me so much. It's because it's like everything is like real compact. You know what I'm saying? And everything is together.
Yeah, bro. I am the complete.
That's where we opposite, bro. Like,
I need stuff spread out. I need some room.
Bro, I remember.
I like the fact that niggas in New York can walk everywhere, bro. I like
that. Yeah, that's true. I also like driving though.
Yeah, bro. Like, if I get a
I would never drive New York, bro. That's just a fight waiting to happen that I ain't got time for.
Yeah. I could not imagine trying to commute in New York every single day of my life.
Imagine trying to go to work. I mean, you just gonna take a bus or a subway or something?
No, I'm telling you, bro.
I mean, New York got all types of public transportation. They ain't public, bro. You city bus,
that's what
city bus and car.
Mm-hmm.
They got subways.
Hell across the cool.
I mean, shit, you can do that too.
Then I could pick me or just take me downtown, Mike. I'll walk.
Even like
fucking, I will say though.
Oh, go ahead, Rodney.
New York is probably one of the best looking cities in the United States. I will say that though.
That's what I'm saying.
They actually take care of it.
I'm an aesthetic type nigga. You know what I'm saying?
I just like the way shit looks.
Bro, one place I don't think I could live, bro, is LA, bro.
Nah, done deal.
LA is weird, bro. Cause it's like so many niggas live in LA, but they really live in like the Valley or like somewhere around that shit, bro.
Valley of Crenshaw. It's like all American good.
They don't really mess with LA like that, bro. Yeah. You know, they live in the suburbs.
Niggas don't even really like Dallas. Niggas really don't even be in LA, bro. They be in California. They be real close. It's kind of how niggas in Texas are with Houston. Niggas don't really be in Houston. Niggas be real close to Houston, though.
They be in like Beaumont.
niggas be real close to Houston.
Yeah, bro, that is like Dallas, though. Like, don't one really be in Dallas. They be in Plano.
They be in Arlington. They be in Denver. They be in Denver.
You know, Mesquite.
They be in Irvine.
Inside Frisco. You know.
Fort Worth.
Even really be in Fort Worth, bro. They be in, like, you know, Cedar Hill, you know.
Niggas in New York really be in New York. You know what I'm
saying? Well, yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
well, they ain't got nowhere to spread out. Like, in New York or New Jersey, like, literally just go a few miles to, like, what, the west? And then you in New Jersey. You in a completely different state. I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
Well, that's like, bro. I went and visited, like, I got some kinfolk that live in St. Louis, bro. Bro, and the houses are, like, so close there, bro. I can stretch my arms out and touch the next house, bro.
Bro, them Midwest houses are, like, not the move to me. Like, bro, Chicago, like, houses and Detroit houses.
I was walking up there,
houses.
Bro, and I seen somebody in the bathroom that needed some toilet tissue. I could damn near just hand it to them across the house.
Hey, Jeff!
I could just be like, hey, bro, let's open your window. And I could damn near just hand it to them.
But, you know, another place that I considered living until I went to was the West Coast in Portland.
Portland, Oregon?
I'm about going to Oregon.
Fuck, no.
Well,
nigga
I got to live
that nigga trying to be
for real.
That nigga trying to join Nike.
They trying to get a sponsor
for real. I got, I got a family in Portland, so I mean, we visit all the time. It's just a different area.
I've never been to Oregon, so I don't even know what the fucking layout to Oregon is like, bro.
Nothing about Oregon makes me be like, Devin, you need to go there.
Bro, have you ever been to Vintage Township in Lubbock and see those houses?
I probably have, just don't know the name.
They're by the HEB.
I ain't even been to HEB.
I gotta take y'all there, but the houses are kind of like that a little bit.
That nigga said it's like kind of like Chicago houses in a way.
Alright, he said he's gonna take us
on a
road trip.
Nigga.
You might look on a road trip.
And our favorite, Chevy Malibu.
Cruising through Lubbock. Little lifestyle. Oh, wow. This is wild. You might little black boy.
Oh, shit.
Bro, what would Jordan be saying? Little moon crickets.
Yeah. Climb aboard, getting ready to explore your afros. In the Cantu section, black hair.
Bro, I heard Cantu is not good for your hair, bro.
Cantu is not good, bro. We are.
Why did niggas wait so long Cantu to disclose this information, cuz?
For real, bro.
Bro, I've seen that too, bro. And I was like, bro, I'm okay with that because I used to use that, bro.
Bro, and it was like,
I had Cantu all up in my head, bro. And then they're like, nah, bro.
I switched to Shea Moisture, but I'm like, man, maybe it was just y'all hair. Maybe it was just y'all hair. My shit is fine, my name.
No,
what
I'm necessarily
saying about it.
It has alcohol.
Now, they're talking about the chemicals and all that. It dries your hair out.
But that's the thing. It wasn't drying my shit out. It wasn't doing that shit tomorrow. That's why I'm like, man, maybe I'm just like mixed and it's different.
Yeah,
bro,
you
exempt from the rule. Well, we talking about black people here, black.
I still swish. My hair is black. My should be nappy than a bitch.
Fam.
Hey, dude, you got bro. The best of both worlds, bro.
Hey, bro, Devin, would you rather comb my hair or Sean's hair?
Well, my hair is combed out right now, and I consistently comb my hair out.
More likely be Sean.
Even when
it's going to be Sean's hair, bro.
Even when my hair was stupid fucking long, I still combed it out damn near daily. That shit used to take
me like an
hour.
You know what I think is crazy, though? Like, Albuquerque, New Mexico is real life, like really, like, fucking big. Which is wild to me, because who the fuck lives in New Mexico, bro?
No, I have this YouTuber I watch,
you know
bro.
Who litter.
I have this YouTuber I watch who lives in Albuquerque, nigga, and he be prospering. So I'm like, shit.
Bro, you know a place that I would move to, though, that's not Georgia or Austin?
Las Vegas. Fuck no, it's too damn hot out there, boy.
Bro,
I ain't moving nowhere to New Mexico, bro. That's crazy over there.
I'll move to Albuquerque.
Right, cuz.
They be having fucking snow.
I'll be working down there, bro. Just because it's crazy in New Mexico, bro.
How they are. Fucking Mexicans.
Bro, you know, like, how roadkill be, bro?
Roadkill?
Yeah, bro.
Bro, if they killed
on the road.
Yeah, like, if they get hit by a car or something like that. Bro, yeah. Like, if cattle get hit by a car, bro, in New Mexico, bro, they cut the heads off, bro.
Bro, we have...
I thought they was just playing, but, like, I literally seen it one day.
Now y'all can have... On the way back from
tour last year, we were somewhere in fucking New Mexico. It was cold as shit, my man. And on the way back, bro, we were on like a fucking hill, and a fucking not a hill. It was like somewhere, bro. And a cow was like, it was like a herd of cows in the middle of the fucking road because one cow got hit, and they were all like surrounding that thing. Bro, we was there for like 30 minutes trying to get around this shit, bro.
I would have let them alone, G.
Oh, we did. We were just like, we like edged real close and like honked the horn, hoping niggas would move out the way, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, where them hoes would have charged after y'all?
I was in a bus, my nigga. I was going to be straight.
Damn, that was. Yeah, all right, cool. We gonna wait till the ambulance get here, pal. We got.
Lubbock Christian would have got sued, my nigga. Had something happen to me. Niggas was gonna pay my tuition.
You was gonna sue Lubbock Christian, bro?
I'm waiting for a reason to get these niggas in trouble, boy. They don't even fucking know.
Oh, yeah.
My boy gonna be sitting in Brooklyn right now. Nigga.
I'm gonna get that check from them. So you said smoothly what? Drop out.
Just wait for him to say something racist.
I tell y'all that shit. The teacher, one of my teachers already kind of did.
Wait, which one was it again?
In my fucking, what's that class? Elementary music methods. She said it's okay to teach, she said it was okay to teach the racist, like, nursery rhymes and folk songs to kids because they've always been like that and that we're just overreacting now.
Wow.
Yeah. But I had that handled, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to my RD. Because I was just going to say nothing and just, like, fuck that bitch class.
Mm-hmm.
And then the musical, they tried to make me sing a fucking,
Oh, hell.
What's it called?
Be a slave.
No, fuck no. Damn, what is this shit called? It's like a song making fun of black people. It's like a certain name, but I can't think of what it is right now. It was in a musical.
Bro, the ice cream song?
No, it was called Shortening Bread.
Oh my god!
He didn't say the title of it. Yeah.
That just sound bad,
bro. Shortening Bread.
Yeah. So I'm not doing musicals here no more. If y'all couldn't.
Yeah, I don't think I would.
And they doing Hairspray next year. So.
Nah, I would.
They don't have to hire.
What's it? Is it called Negro Wednesday or something crazy, bro?
What? I don't know. I actually learned the name of it, and I can't remember what it is.
Hairspray. It was it's something.
Oh, Negro Day.
Negro Day.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Bro, I just can't see. Bro, imagine like Coronado performing Hairspray. Nah, we gotta pick a racist school. Like Lovett Cooper performing Hairspray.
You said a racist school. Hilarious.
Then I said Lovett Cooper. Bro, I can't believe they didn't put that MAGA 2020. They wasted all that paint.
Mm. Oh, nah, I believe it.
I'm just sick though. Lovett Cooper, bro. Remember they painted MAGA 2020.
I'm talking about
Trump 2020.
The original topic. What was the original topic?
Oh shit.
Niggas got off.
Moving out the city, bro.
Okay, back to it. Okay. Bro, but I feel like I could move to a city, bro. Like I feel like I'd be straight. But it'd be some things I'd have to get straight before I move to a city, bro.
Now, there's only a few exceptions where I see moving to the city is actually a pretty good investment. Dan, do I name drop right now? I'm going to just name drop.
Just don't say it multiple times.
Yeah. So, right. She's trying to get into the film industry. Yeah, bro. You might need to go hang it up out of Lubbock for that, you know.
Film industry.
She basically... Yeah, she's trying to get to where she's, like, filming, like movies, bro.
All right. Like,
you know what I'm saying? We already got a couple of them here, you know what I'm saying? We just had to make sure, you know what I'm saying? We ain't know what type of time she was on.
So, like, she ended up having to move to Florida to go to film school, and she was like, yeah, I'm either going live in L.A. or Vancouver or something where they actually filming, you know, movies and stuff. So I was like, oh, yeah, that makes sense. She's like, if I ever end up in Lubbock for more than 3 months, something went wrong in my career. I'm like, damn. Okay. I'm like, wow.
I ain't no filthy going on.
But, just for that, I'd be like, yeah, bro, I'm going to make a movie studio in Lubbock. Just to do shit.
Just to piss you off.
Bro, that's why I said to Jordan when he was like, yeah, bro, you ain't gonna build nothing to Lubbock. I'm gonna make a Nike, bro. Just to spite you.
Bro, like, it's stuff you can build an empire in Lubbock, bro. Like, bro, he really can, bro.
And if you actually look at the history of Lubbock, and this is what kills me about Lubbock, Texas, bro, we had some stupid policies that completely killed the growth of Lubbock. Lubbock could be the same size as Austin, bro. Like, kid you not.
Lubbock has all the potential to be the West Texas Metroplex, bro.
I mean, it technically, well, there's...
Nah, El Paso got us.
Well, I ain't even talking about El Paso in the mountain, bro.
El Paso, basically, down. Mexico, you ask me.
Yeah, El Paso, Mexico.
That's the same shit.
West Texas.
Yeah, same thing.
But, fuck, bro, you don't threw me off. Well, yeah, of course, El Paso gonna have it. Bitch ass El Paso. But they also, not from Mexico. They on the freaking border, bro.
I've never been
like,
to El Paso. Now that I think about that shit.
Wait, how big is El Paso?
Border, bro.
I've never been to El Paso. So I don't even know what that shit look like.
It's far, bro.
It's in a bowl.
I know where it is. I just don't know what it looks like. You know what I'm saying?
It's in a bowl. Trust me. It's in a bowl.
Yeah, El Paso.
I imagine that shit looking like Mexico. Probably like Roswell or some cool shit.
Roswell? But like...
But like 20 times bigger.
Yeah.
El Paso's bigger. I didn't know that.
El Paso got like over a million people living there.
El Paso is like gigantic. Not gigantic, but in Lubbock Sanders, yeah, bro.
We like a suburb in El Paso.
They got a lot of shit down there.
They got what?
They got a lot of shit down there.
Yeah, it's they got more than us.
They got a subway? Is that what you said?
No, I said they got more than
us. No, I'm talking about Devin.
Sure they do got a subway.
I thought Devin said they have a subway.
Nah.
Oh.
Yeah,
know.
Bro, El Paso is sitting around like 700,000-800,000 people. Lubbock Metro is 300,000. That's being generous. So, yeah. They up there, bro.
They pretty big.
They ain't like Dallas or nothing. Like, you know.
Bro, it's like literally the border between the old Mexico and New Mexico.
Yeah bro.
I knew that.
Real talk, El Paso had all the potential it needed to be like fat as hell. Because it's right there. It's at the border of, like, two countries and, like, three states.
Difference. Oh, God, bro. Because
I think, what state is this? Chihuahua? Yeah.
You said two countries?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, Mexico.
U.S. and Mexico.
Oh, nigga, you said the border of two countries.
Yeah, bro.
I wasn't counting the fucking U.S., nigga. I was like, what other country, nigga?
Like, wait a minute, that's another country.
I know, I was like,
wait a minute, it's another one in there?
I know. No, I thought you were saying, like, it's on the border of two other countries. So I was like, what the fuck?
No.
I was like, what the fuck?
Nah, the U.S. only borders,
Canada and Mexico.
Technically, they border Russia, too, but we ain't gonna count Alaska. So, we gonna leave that alone.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro, it gets complicated. We ain't even gonna worry about it all that.
I don't even get how we have Alaska. This is basically part of Canada.
Bro, you wanna know the story about Alaska,
That's
bro?
How you know. I don't know shit about
really
you.
Oh, okay. I was like, if you wanna know the story, I could tell you, but
I'll learn it another day.
You said that shit is
Canada. I'll make it short.
Canada.
I'll make it short.
How the fuck is Alaska
Russia
Canada?
Was basically cause? Getting their ass looked by it was either Japan or Germany. They were in a civil war, Marco. I'm getting this all type of fucked up. But basically they didn't know how to defend Alaska and they were just like, fuck it, we gonna sell this bitch and yeah.
No way. But we just bought them.
Yeah. US just went like, yeah, I buy that shit.
I get that up off you cool. So we can
bro, cool. Real talk, like, U.S. is really, like, big as hell when you think about it, bro.
Oh, it is.
It's the third biggest country in the world in both size and population.
What's the first two? China and who else?
Russia.
Russia and Canada are bigger in size, and China and India are bigger in population.
So we like
China. They're fertile like mess.
Bro, China. Bro, we ever get into a war with China, bro, every one of us is like four Chinese people, bro. Like,
shit,
that's...
I'm in the house, too. I'm like, damn, my four of
the kids
killed like three times.
Racist, bro.
I think I might be able to beat... We might be able to beat four Chinese people up, though. Each person.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
So I'm not even worried
for
about
sure.
that. Like, dude, them niggas got hands like that, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm really worried about.
I'm telling you, bro, I'm being that much. One of them pop clubs, like, four different times.
China is a stronger opponent than Russia, I tell you that. If you're worried about a war, you need to be more worried about China than Russia. For a fact. Like, for sure.
I ain't in war with nobody.
Yep. Nah, for real. Unless they blow up Lubbock, Texas, bro, I ain't going to war.
I'm not a nigga, they can blow up like a nigga. They ain't got shit to do with me, man. Shit.
Bro, when they blow up Eastside, bro, when they blow up Bates, bro.
Nigga, I don't
Bates
think...
is gonna be blew up.
Nigga.
Because I'm like that thing.
I ain't gonna work with nobody.
Hell no.
You blow up my block, you got it.
Fuck all that, nigga. That's me. That's you at that point.
What I'm block, gonna you can blow up me.
Exactly. That's what I'm gonna do.
It's like, oh, you gonna fight the missile, bro? You gonna fight the bullet?
I'm great.
Serious question.
Let's say China attacks us, right? And we get into a war, and you get drafted. You
going? I'm going to jail, nigga. I'm gonna serve my little jail
sentence.
I'm gonna serve my little sentence, and I'm gonna be good, my nigga.
I don't know. The only reason I say I might serve is just
I'm gonna go out there and fight for my shit.
Nah, bro. I'm in a military family, so they gonna be like, bro, come on.
My family could be like, come on. I'm like, fuck no. Y'all think you got me bent?
We just gotta win, bro. We gotta win. But, like, y'all gotta win. I'm gonna go get the jumpsuit.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, bro. Because what y'all not about to do is hand me no AR-15 and tell me to go shoot some Chinese folk for y'all, because y'all messed up.
I'm gonna be in that mud shit. They got ones in prison.
Hey, bro, I'm gonna join the Air Force. I'm gonna join the Air Force, and they gonna have me stationed in Lubbock.
Hell no. Fuck all that.
Alright. You gonna go ahead and take that charge.
I'm gonna take that commissary.
For shit,
so. Y'all gonna be posting me.
Is it not what he do? You ain't gonna fight for the white folks?
Yeah, I think jail might be. If they do some shit like that, bro, the amount of niggas who are willing to just go to jail. The jail
gonna be live.
Hell no, they not even gonna be able to take no more people. They're gonna be like, hey man, whatever, my nigga. You don't even gotta do that.
Start building
the jail full, my nigga. We can't even take you, my nigga.
Bro, due to COVID, bro, we can't even have like, y'all in here.
Yeah. I didn't know this many niggas was gonna go to jail, man.
We didn't know all y'all wasn't gonna be here.
We thought at least some of y'all niggas would go. Shit.
I don't know what Donald Trump was doing, but dang, like, we ain't about to take all y'all niggas.
I don't want none of you anyway.
Low key, that's probably what would happen, low key. It'll probably be so many niggas. It'll probably be like so many niggas. Send me to jail. They'd be like, huh? Wait a minute. It's too many.
That's not how it's supposed to go.
It'll be a couple jails will get full, and the niggas will be like, all right, never mind. You don't got to go to jail no more.
That's what I thought.
I'm going to let all them good old boys go get killed first. Mm-hmm. I'll come do the cleanup.
Fuck all that.
You don't
have
to love a Cooper boys.
I'll
fight for my country.
Yeah, I'm gonna let all them go on over there first.
That's what happened in Vietnam when we got our shit murked, nigga.
It got clapped, boy.
We got murked.
Yes, straight up.
Them niggas beat the goofy shit out our ass, boy.
Bro, we went to because we were really like, because we just won World War II. You know, we thought we was that nigga.
Guerrilla warfare wasn't meant for us, and they won.
That's what happened. Niggas was ready to get drafted, And them Viet niggas got dead on their ass.
Bro, that Viet Cong, bro, they were in the trees with AKs, bro. Like, how do you fight that?
Them niggas got too much. They know way
bro, they had it. Booby traps, bro. You was walking, you don't step. Now you in a barricade, bro. About to get your shit just mollywalk, bro.
Them niggas wanted that smoke.
Your ankle just slide off.
They been waiting for that shit, boy. They was ready.
He's like, oh, I've been waiting for y'all.
Yeah, that's
waiting for y'all, nigga.
That's why I'm like, fuck no, you're not finna drive me to shit. I'm not finna end up like none of them niggas, man.
Yeah, bro, because you know the war ain't gonna be in the U.S., bro. They gonna send you to India, bro. They gonna send you to, like, you know, Iraq, bro.
Nigga, a good portion of the Vietnam niggas got drafted, was not in the army on their own shit, and now all the niggas is fucking traumatized and dead. Fuck no, bro.
Bro, they can't even see anyone from Vietnam no more, bro. They gonna try.
And they didn't even want to be there in the first place. That's some crazy shit.
Bro, I'm telling you, bro. I don't even want to be sitting there, but yeah, we finna go ahead and ship you off to Afghanistan, but you been at Rikers Island.
Nigga, oh God. Send me to Alcatraz, nigga. Fuck all that.
You mean Lubbock County?
Nigga.
Yeah, because I ain't gonna go to especially not no Afghanistan, bro. Fuck like, man.
Them niggas just dry out there. They don't even doing shit. They shoot niggas, bro. And they don't even know why.
Right. Oh, God.
Them niggas is like, man.
Bro, after killing people.
He's like, this is for freedom, I guess.
Niggas is like,
freedom for who?
You go out there and ask a gunman, like, why is he out here shooting people, man? I don't even fucking know no more, man. We started this shit in, like, 2001, and niggas is just still here. I don't even know what's going on.
Bro, we like Crips and Bloods, bro. Like, we just dry start shooting, bro, for no reason.
Bro, especially in Iraq, bro. Like, people don't really talk about the Iraq war. Like, this is one thing I wanted to say to Miss Harris so bad, but I just held hold my tongue. She combines the Iraq war and the Afghanistan war as the same war, bro. I'm like, nah, folks, it wasn't. We went to Iraq for no reason, bro.
That
like,
said she's gonna fill your life. That's hilarious.
For real. But, bro, we really went to Iraq for no reason, bro.
Bro, when they say we were searching for weapons of mass destruction?
No, who's saying they had no dang mass destruction, bro?
Bro, it was funny because Steve Harvey made a show about it. He was like, so, man, we've been over there again in 50 years. He said, we ain't found a firecracker.
Nigga, on God, bro. Niggas, that's what I'm saying, bro. Niggas is dry out there. Niggas forgot why they sent people out there at this point. They trying to figure out why niggas is out there so they can bring people back.
Niggas
like, shit, nigga, is
we'll try to bring you back. Niggas why like, shit. Were we there, bro?
Then niggas like, shit, is the mission done? I don't know. I don't know, man.
Bro,
it's
successful. Part, bro. They started bringing people back, right? But they blew up Iraq, bro, and that let ISIS come up because ain't nobody was in the country, bro. It was just a big old empty country, like.
They're 35-0-1
because
they still pinned
in
that one.
Boy.
They don't know what's going on. I don't know if we won or lost, so I guess 35-0-1.
So, I tell you about what happened in Afghanistan. Afghanistan was a retaliation to 9/11, right? They were going after Al-Qaeda. They were stationed somewhere in the hills in the mountains of Afghanistan. Iraq was some bullshit. Bush just said, yeah, he got some nukes. And we just sent an entire army, bro.
We finna go find them. Oh, God.
Yeah, so we finna find them, bitch.
And freaking, bro, it's just, what we just did at the Middle East, bro.
I thought we'd be, bro.
Nah, what was, 21 Savage said? I whoop all these niggas.
Oh, God. I beat you. And I'll be the good man.
Bro, we went up into Baghdad, bro, and then we just got stuck. That's what happened.
We shouldn't do
like a light skin, bitch.
We need to leave all that shit over there to Jesus, my nigga. That is his land. Let him figure that out.
They heard what George Washington said.
Man, that is Jesus' place. Let him figure that shit out. You know what I'm saying?
And his farewell people. Address, cuz, said we need to stay out of foreign affairs. Stay out of all of
And bro, Americans now, we're just like, yeah, we're going to ignore that.
Yeah, yeah.
We're going to ignore everything about that real quick. Cause bro, that Middle East is jacked up, and it's our fault. Like, people think that, like, the Middle East is jacked up because of Muslims. Like, nah, folks, it's us.
You know what's crazy?
We ain't have to go in there and attack them folks. They mind their business, bro.
You know what's crazy? I didn't know we lost Vietnam until we learned about that shit in Coach Wade's class.
Oh, Coach Wade wasn't going to lie.
In my mind, I was like, shit, we ain't lost shit yet because we still here and prospering on there, but damn.
Yeah.
They got on our shit, boy.
I was like, we ain't never lost a war yet. And then we get to Coach Wade's class, we end up losing like 2-3 wars. I'm like, damn.
Oh, shit.
We low-key suck.
They got, oh, God. I walked out of Coach Wade's class. I was like, shit, maybe they might need a real nigga in the military. Maybe. Shit, we not doing too hard.
Bro, they lied to me all of elementary school, bro. Had us thinking America was this greatest country ever. And if we just actually learned, I'm like, damn, y'all racist.
We got beat up by
and y'all lost wars.
We got beat up by the Asians at anything. Shit, nigga, the Asians. Not even like Russia or no big niggas. The Asians.
The Asians, bro. And it wasn't China or them, bro. It was Vietnam. They were in trees with AKs, bro.
Them niggas
we
ain't
had
having
bombs and planes.
Them niggas ain't have nothing over there. So they robbed our ass, boy. They took
that shit. They had them hands.
Nigga.
We had Nagasaki and Hiroshima.
Yeah, bro, and we thought we was the shit, bro. We thought we blew up Japan. People in Vietnam was like, try that shit over here.
That nigga said, all right. Come over here with that shit, my nigga. Vietnam was the definition of coming the fuck you don't want the fucking Desi video. That's what Vietnam was.
Bro, Devin, you got that one video with that bird? Freaking, he's like, you try that shit again. And he fucking grabbed that nigga by the neck, bro. Yeah, that was Vietnam, boy. They whooped our ass. Man, they coming back here with PTSD and shit because freaking Black Hawk helicopters are crashing and
that shit was fun to learn about. That shit was crazy. I was like, damn, them niggas was really dead on our ass for no reason.
Bro, that low key makes like history fun though. Whenever you like actually learn like the ugly parts that they don't talk about.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, bro, we lost that bitch. Like bad.
Yeah, like you remember all this stuff they told you through elementary up to now?
Yeah, they lied to
that ain't true.
That nigga
America is not the greatest country ever.
Because we got our hands handed to us, man.
Actually, niggas took us in some trees and we was like, what the fuck are we supposed to do here? You know what I'm saying?
Real
talk. Niggas took us to a forest. We was like, oh shit.
He's like, this wasn't in training, bro. Like, I was training in Albuquerque, New Mexico. We ain't have no trees like this.
Low key. Niggas is doing basic training in Texas. Niggas got drafted. Ain't never seen a tree in their life.
Bro, did I tell you about my stupid cousin, bro? So, we're in East Texas, bro, and my cousin and one of his friends were over here, and we were talking, right? He said, yeah, bro, I'm gonna go to Oklahoma for basic training. This nigga said, oh, for what, the Navy?
So the Navy?
I was like, for the Navy? Basic training in Oklahoma, bro. I said, the Navy, bro? Like, yeah, they could have a boat in a swimming pool or something. I was like, y'all tripping, man.
The niggas using the lake out there. They're out there training in the pond and shit.
Yeah, out there in Tulsa. It's like, nah, bro. Bro, imagine Navy training in freaking Canyon Lake, Dunbar Lake, bro.
Shit, man.
Yeah, that's basically what we did for the niggas in Vietnam. They said, all right, y'all, this is what you're going to see. Got to Vietnam was confused.
So y'all seen,
like,
y'all
trained for niggas in
y'all seen woods, right? Y'all seen woods. All right. Well, these ones is this is wet. This is wet woods, my nigga. This is what this is, my nigga. The shit is green.
Got Vietnam, bro. They were getting bit by dog-sized dragonflies. Like it's some crazy stuff in that forest, bro. You don't leave that alone.
Niggas was seeing all this shit, boy. Niggas was seeing kimono dragons and some other shit.
Bro, are they in Vietnam, bro?
No, probably
not. They in that area.
I don't know. It was racism a little bit, whatever.
Yeah, it's racist, I know.
Asians, dragons, same shit.
Dragons. Oh, look, bro, real talk, what would you do, bro, if Chinese just pulled like a real life dragon out in the middle of war and be like, yeah, fuck y'all.
Okay, I'm like scared of niggas like that, bro. Because if they, if, well, they if like, some like real, like, nah, because them niggas really be like, no, like monks and shit. Like, if them, oh, niggas, yeah, if them niggas start joining war, boy, I'm gonna be like, man, I might, we might have to switch, man, because them niggas is nice, man.
Yeah, like, we gonna go ahead and see what's going on in Mars, bro. I just hope we have a Mars colony before we go back to war, because I'm gonna be like, yeah, bro, I'm gonna chill on Mars while y'all figure this shit out.
Well, because, nigga, fuck no. Them. Cause once monks niggas start doing war shit, I'm like, fucking nope. We ain't got no monks in Lubbock, bro. Nigga. Don't nobody know that shit. Them niggas be levitating in some more shit, bro. I'm not finna do that.
Bro, like, you know, Japanese samurais and shit, bro.
Nah, fuck no, them niggas is really trained. We gonna be shooting, niggas is gonna be hitting that shit right out there.
Boy. Bro, they gonna be freaking having to block it up with the sword like ping, nigga, ping, ping, ping. Oh, hell.
Boy, G.I. Joe, them niggas is snake eyes. Boy, fuck are you talking about?
Them well, you are in trouble, there, folks. Real tall. I ain't gonna mess with them. Hell. Not with no Chinese motherfucker that know Kung Fu. Yo ass in trouble.
It'll be 10 of them niggas and 100 of us. It'll be none of us and nine of them niggas left. I promise.
Oh, God.
They gonna continue to run through our shit.
And, bro, they already have 4 people to every one of us. Like, we gonna get clapped, bro. All they gotta do is just drop, like, 10,000 of them in Texas, bro. That's it. U.S. is done. War over with, bro. That's wild to me.
Man, we got way off topic. How the fuck did we start talking about wars and shit?
Bro, hey, Devin, is Devin still there?
Man, he's asleep.
Man, wake your bitch ass up.
I don't think, man, I think he was up there. I don't know.
Yeah, he was probably going to go get something to drink. Go take a shit.
Well, fuck it. How's your beat making going? You got anything yet?
Let's see. I got.
I ain't gonna drop that song off, bro.
Oh, yeah, for real. What am I doing tomorrow? Fuck. You were supposed to come a few days ago, then we just, like, forgot. Yeah. I have this concept I was working on, but I don't even think this shit gonna play for me. You bitch ass bitch.
You bitch ass bitch.
But yeah, I was just messing with stuff on the album. But yeah, that need to be mixed.
I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I'm low-key about to go to sleep.
Yeah, bro, we can tell.
Alright, well,
we went through the entire war scenario.
Wikipedia, what was this? I don't know, my name. What's the title going to be?
Entourage.
This was something, though, man.
Yeah, bro.
This was something.
This was just conversations. This was just niggas talking, bro.
Yep. So.
Niggas talking.
More videos coming soon. Reactions once we figure out how to get that shit working.
Yeah, bro. I think that's something we should do in person. Like, that's just going to be easy. Yeah.
Set up. Sure. We'll be done one of these fucking days. Yeah.
Today's
yes, sir. Y'all make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe.
This KKL Beats.
Oh. This wasn't really an episode, but y'all want to give a gem? Y'all have any?
Off the top of your head?
This wasn't really an episode, but do y'all want to give a gem?
Shit, let me check my Spotify.
I got you right now, because I'm finna get off. Right, boy, the eyes are struggling.
Go ahead, Devin.
This is...
Mom's Let Me Know by Juice WRLD.
Just feel the vibe, so let me know, let me know, let me know what's up with you. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you comfortable. Oh.
This ain't really a gem because it's an old song, but I went back to one of the old Drake stuff and I actually messed with it, so it can't take a drop. I ain't listen to Scorpion like all the way through. So then I said, all right, I'll listen to it.
I'm going to do The Vapors, Janae Aiko, and Vince Staples. Can I hit it again?
Please don't rain on my parade. The falling from the sky just remind me of the days when you was crying for attention. I ignored it as a phase until you couldn't take the tension. Now I wish you would've stayed.
Yes, sir. Right. Yes, sir.
Well, me and Ronnie gonna talk about beat shit, but... oh,
you're trying to get it. I ain't ate yet.
Yeah,
right. Oh, shit.
You don't know. Well, Wikipedia, we out.
Bitch nigga looking at me stupid, ruthless. Y'all ain't tough enough to talk stupid. Who's this? Best one, I don't even do this. Cooling, cruising. Bitch nigga looking at me.